Hey guys, welcome to Fallout 3.
I don't want to set the world on fire.
So we're doing Fallout 3 now. I played about 3 hours of this. I played quite a bit into it. Well, actually, not into it at all, because I played DLC only. I cheated to get to the DLC. I love the console, right? But I had to restart because it's on my other computer, and I'm too lazy to switch all that crap over. So let's restart and do it legit for you guys. I probably will never get very far. So, but yeah, doing this for you guys. It shouldn't be too loud. I guess I'm gonna have to check if it's too loud after this cutscene. Gonna go back and check.
I've lost all ambition.
So yeah, I'm gonna assume you guys know what Fallout is about if you're watching this, but if you don't, post-apocalyptic world, after an apocalyptic war, nuclear war.
I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of.
Right. Yeah. Place is desolate. When you play the game, you feel lonely. You feel lonely. That's why I got you guys along for the ride. That guy is a fox. Okay, well this is pretty loud for me, so I don't know if you guys will be able to hear it. I'll wait till we're into like the setup screen, right, in my name and shit, and then I'll see if I gotta configure the audio or whatnot.
War. War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything, from God to justice to simple psychotic rage.
This game has a really powerful message.
In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world. But war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
So I'm thinking of playing a full evil character, because I've never done it in any games. I've always played the full good guy, but I also know that full evil only brings, like, bad stuff upon you. So I'm wondering. I'll have to turn on subtitles. But we're going to wait till the cutscenes are done.
Let's see. Are you a boy or a girl?
He's asking me if I'm a boy or a girl. Okay, well, guys, I'm going to end the recording here, and we'll get you guys back in after I fix the audio, make sure all the settings are right, and turn on subtitles, if I can. Well, see you guys in a minute. Okay, we're back. So, the audio is pretty good there. I decided to put the master volume down just a little bit. Subtitles. No subtitles there. Display? Subtitle. Dialogue subtitles on. General subtitles on. Crosshair on. There we go. So, I think I'm going to play a good character.
A boy. We've got a son, Catherine.
Damn it, put your fucking subtitles on.
Healthy baby boy.
There we go.
Oh, James.
Because this is even not very loud for me. But I don't want to make it so it overpowers me at points. Because, yeah.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure.
I'm going to try and not talk during their dialogue.
Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about...
Let's call ourselves player name, right? I guess we'll call ourselves Mator. Because that's my traditional name.
That's a good name, don't you think? Fits you perfectly.
I'm still trying to decide what character I'm going to roll. I would roll melee, but... Cool. Well, I guess that. Preset. The presets are all unbelievably ugly, and I'm too lazy to customize. So we're just going to go for this one. Or wait. Yes. Ew. So there's no hair changes here? We just slowly get uglier? There we go. Hairstyle. Definitely. Hair color. Yellow. For sure. And yes, the scruff. Wait. Which one's more scruffy? Why does it feel weird that I have a beard that's yellow? You'd think they'd give you a color for it. You know, they might. This is boring shit. Here with my first choice. The gunslinger. Epic mustache time. Yes.
You're going to look a lot like your dad.
Really? I'm going to look like my dad?
Oh.
Okay.
Very strapping.
I'm going to look like nothing.
It's a big world out there, son.
I'm going to look like the biggest punk ever.
What about you? What kind of person are you going to be? You're
James?
Just... Catherine?
James?
What kind of person am I going to be?
Arrest. Start compressions. James. Get the baby out of here. Move! Move! Start compression. Get the baby out of here.
Hey guys, we're back. It crashed.
Hang on, Catherine.
I don't know why. That sucks. But I know something. F9, which is my record key, is quick load.
Look straight into the light.
James and his cheery chatter.
Decorations.
May your future be bright.
This place will feel just like home. Come on over here, son. Come on.
Okay.
Walk to daddy.
Walk to daddy. No. A baby and I'm bouncing.
There you go.
He looks younger.
Goodness, just a year old and already walking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo, I know you don't like it when daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, pal. I'll be back in a bit.
Okay, I understand you'll be back in a bit. No, we're gonna use the ninja approach. Damn it, baby, you can't jump work Jack. I don't wanna open the gate, I wanna jump over the gate. Oh, whatever. Yeah. you're special. S is for strength, and that means I am strong. I can carry more toys and swing stuff all day long. P is for perception, along from the word. It means what I tasted, smelled, saw, and heard. E is for endurance, and that's how long I can play. I'm always really healthy and have energy all day. C is for charisma. It's why people think I'm great. I make my friends all laugh and smile and never want to hate. You get 2 points in there. One point in there. 2 points in there. Because we're going to be a gunslinger. I think we're going to go down one in strength. So I can give another point to agility. I don't think I need perception. Yeah. I already looked at it. Do I have to look again?
You are quite a little
teddy bear.
Roar! Me right for trying to pin you in.
Kick your ass, bitch. I'm out.
I want to show you something. See that? It was your mother's favorite.
Who the hell are you talking to? Bible. Teddy bear, protect me.
I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst at the fountain of the water of life, really. He always loved that.
Hello.
All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amato wants to play.
Can I bring my teddy bear? Can I bring my teddy bear like a boss? Oh yeah. Damn, I'm hungry. I've got a sandwich like 3 feet away from me, like garlic, less than a foot away from me, but I'm recording instead of eating.
Stanley, you turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Where am I?
Happy birthday.
See, he looks still young. Everyone here is so ugly.
Happy birthday.
Can I kill them all?
I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your
congratulations,
mother.
Young man. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well, you're ready to take on your first official vault responsibilities. So here you are. As overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy
3000. Yeah, man. Pip-Boy 3000. I hate this thing. It tells me that I have no stim packs and that I'm at low health.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once.
I hate having low health, man.
Happy birthday. We really surprised you, didn't
we? Well, I feel like I'm taller right now because I was in the air.
I was afraid.
Should I be jerkish or... I don't know. This is a dilemma. Oh, whatever.
You're welcome. But, hey, I bet you can't guess what I got you for your birthday. Go on, guess. Ha! I knew I surprised you. Who's your favorite barbarian? That's right, Grognak. Issue 14. And with no missing pages.
Oh my god, no missing pages.
I found it in a box of my father's old things. Believe it or not. Imagine him reading comic books. I guess everybody was 10 once. Well, I better let you get back to mingling.
Blah, 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 blah.
Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything. I know that, Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right? Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to, you know.
He's a peer pressured kid.
Hey, Wally, I think Paul's gone solo.
Hello, Butch.
Yeah, Paul. Why don't you introduce us to your new best friend?
Hello, Andy. You just raped my cake.
How's it going, pal?